On Billboard tonight, Public Art in Grimsby, Adam Ant in Hull and Tom Cruise in Film Review. Welcome to Billboard with me, Ted Stanley, for our monthly roundup of arts and entertainment in East Yorkshire and Lincolnshire. The 2022 Ham & House International Literary Prize is open for entries until September, with substantial cash prizes and opportunities for publication. Categories include short stories, poetry, script writing, songwriting and comedy. The international judging panel are looking forward to reading your entries. Other literary news now from journalist and broadcaster Hugh Richards with a review of the latest book releases.
Thanks, Ted. A few books for a sizzling British summer, even if it's not going to be easy to reach a beach this year. A good dollop of Baroque historical fiction to start. The Second Sight of Zachary Cloudsley by Sean Lusk. Our exotically named hero is born in 18th century London, the happy son of a loving maker of clocks and clockwork automata. He has a psychic skill. With a single touch, he can read the hearts and minds of anybody he meets. Of course, there is a plot point. His father travels to Constantinople, disappears, and leaves a mystery for his perceptive son. It's a tale of mystic visions, intricate engineering, the modernity of an age hundreds of years ago, and a galloping travel story. And Lusk writes in full Technicolor. The Reverend Richard Coles played most of the instruments with Jimmy Somerville in the Communards back in the 80s. Then he became a Church of England priest, a fact he ceaselessly emphasises three times a day on all English language media. He even calls himself Reverend on the cover of his first crime novel, Murder Before Evensong, a title that rather gives away the first act of his plot. The detective is a clergyman, clearly given eccentricities enough to support a series of books and maybe even television. I won't spoil it. This is an unashamed attempt to stow away on the bandwagon of Richard Osman's Thursday Murder Club books. And why not? It's a winning formula because it's such fun. John Grisham is still making a tidy fee by writing stories about lawyers in America. Sparring Partners is a collection of three longish short stories. An attorney must save an old but rather roguish friend. A condemned man must resolve the determination of the courts to kill him. A law firm risks collapse as its partners fight a family feud. Grisham's heroes tend to be youngish idealists in the law, fighting a complacent or corrupt system. These stories are more interesting. While he makes some lawyers improbably admirable, this has very little of the objection, Your Honour, courtroom drama. Sheila Hancock has been one of our most gripping and fascinating actresses for pushing 60 years. She's had an affectionate, rather religious wartime childhood, a brilliant career, a loving family, and wonderful friends. Now, in Old Rage, she reveals that her 80s make her surprisingly angry. She has reason. After a solitary lockdown, she finds herself shouting at the television and talking to birds. Oh, isn't that true of all of us? She reflects on what has made her happy and what infuriates her, always aware of proximate mortality. Hancock always writes with fun and wit, usually with warmth, but she really is cross, and so should we all be. Philip Short has produced a timely and magnificent biography of Vladimir Putin. We already know what he is, but this helps us understand how and why. Righto, Ted. I'm off to spend a couple of weeks sitting around in an airport.
Thank you, Hugh. Some great book choices. Since returning from a period in Spain, talented Grimsby-based artist Francesca Young has been capturing the heritage of her hometown in beautiful watercolour and ink paintings. I caught up with her at a recent Culture House event to find out more about her latest commission for Paint the Town Proud.
I grew up in Cleethorpes and went to school here, then went on to university but in Loughborough to study fine art. I wanted to be an art teacher. Then I thought, not quite ready, don't feel like I've got enough experience yet to be a teacher, so I decided to do a bit of travelling and ended up living in Spain. And I did do an exhibition actually whilst I was out in Spain, looking at, similar to that, what I do here, looking at the culture and the buildings, and I loved that. And I thought, hang on, I haven't even done this in my own town where I grew up yet. I was thinking about doing it, but then it was really during the pandemic that gave me time. In a way, it's like a documentation of how our culture is at the moment. Especially around here, I think we don't have enough work that's celebrating our local area and the heritage, because we do have so much heritage. Just the old buildings with so much character. I like to paint them like a little bit wonkier how they are. I really like the freedom of the watercolour. Once you add the water, you lose control. You have to let go a bit. You can add the pen at the end and kind of bring back the details. So I like the balance of the two. Becky from the Culture House contacted me. And that was it, really. We had a meeting and she told me about the project. How each local artist was going to be given a different brief of something to do with our heritage. I just thought it was a really great idea. My brief was Fishermen's Families. Originally it was just going to be the one painting, but once I started thinking about Fishermen's Families I got this idea in my head of the story of one family and what one family would go through, I just thought, oh, it would be so nice to make it more of a narrative and have like a flow of more than one. I really wanted to focus a lot on the women that were left behind, basically. I loved the idea of the families and the kids and everything. And I think that we have a lot of paintings that look at the men and what the men went through on the boats, but not enough showing what the women at home were doing. I think it's amazing. I think it's really exciting for the area. We need things like this to keep people looking around at the town and realising what we have here and the town's history.
In other art news, the June exhibition at the Hammond House Gallery in Louth features impressive oil landscapes by Cathy Whitehead and beautiful ceramics by Susan Raymer. Music now and a roundup of some of the best gigs around the region with folk singer and music historian Kirsty Hannah.
Britain's premier rhythm and blues band, Dr. Feelgood, make a welcome return to Yardbirds in Grimsby on Friday the 1st of July as part of their European tour. Look forward to Feelgood favourites like Roxette and Milk and Alcohol, and enjoy guest support from Blue Nation. She put it back. She put it back. She put the hard every night just to make me feel alright. Pop icon Adam Ant returns to Hall New Theatre on the 10th of July, with a show that promises to get everyone on their feet. The King of the Wild Frontier will be performing his classic chart-topping singles and personal favourites, including Prince Charming, Stand and Deliver, and Goody Two Shoes. Also at Hall New Theatre on the 16th of July, Scottish singer Eddie Reader features in the UK tour of Jules Holland and his Rhythm and Blues Orchestra. Vandoliers, the alt-country band with punk roots, are at O'Reilly's in Hull on the 4th of July, with their rough edge spin on Texas music. It's twang and tattoos, grit and guitars, honky-tonk and horns, Tejano and Telecasters. And finally, Party in the Park at Normandy Hall on Saturday the 23rd of July promises to be a great day out with Scouting for Girls, leading a lineup of fantastic bands. Expect chart-topping hits of sing-along pop anthems including She's So Lovely, Heartbeat and many more.
I've worked in care on and off for 18 years now. I enjoy it so much. You know, I'm making a real difference to people's lives. It's so rewarding.
I'd encourage people to definitely come in to this sector. I wouldn't do anything else now.
Well, it's a very rewarding job. You're making a difference to people's lives.
I love my job. I think it's a very demanding job, but the outcomes do outweigh that.
I laugh, I smile, I cry with the clients, so they come as part of the family.
Going out and changing their lives, but then they change yours at the same time. It's a lot more rewarding than I thought.
Coming up on tonight's show, Noel Gwynn at the Caxton Theatre and Jimmy Carr in box office. But first, actress and broadcaster Liz Drury with a review of the latest film releases.
Sorry, long night.
Aren't they all? Will you let me make it up to you?
On film review tonight, a powerful story of white supremacy in Master and death-defying stunts from Tom Cruise in Top Gun Maverick. But first, along for the ride, director Sophie Alvarez's latest exploration of teenage drama. It may not reach the giddy heights of her previous trilogy, but it still has a genuine, gentle charm that holds it above most of the offerings in this overcrowded genre. While other teens party in the sun during their last days before college, Lona Auden spends her time roaming the streets after everyone else is asleep. Everything changes when she meets Eli, a charming and mysterious fellow insomniac who challenges Auden to a quest to live out her childhood dreams.
Life is long, Auden. It'd be boring if we had to stay the same versions of ourselves the whole time. It's me.
This is my chance to figure out who I want to be. Before the rest of my life starts.
With a powerful score and creepy cinematography, Master, Mariama Diallo's directorial debut, is a thought-provoking story of racism and white supremacy hidden in an intriguing narrative that tells of a terrifying supernatural evil force. At an elite New England university built on the site of a Salem-era gallows hill, three women strive to find their place. Navigating politics and privilege, they encounter increasingly terrifying manifestations of the school's haunted past and present.
Been on ferreting out who's been terrorizing the student body.
You can't get away from it, Jasmine. It'll follow you. It's everywhere.
Blockbuster movie Top Gun Maverick is a long-awaited sequel that, if anything, surpasses its predecessor in wildly entertaining style. Tom Cruise is back as Pete Maverick Mitchell, one of the US Navy's top aviators, pushing the envelope as a courageous test pilot and dodging the advancement in rank that would ground him. Facing an uncertain future and confronting the ghosts of his past, Maverick is drawn into a confrontation with his own deepest fears, culminating in a mission that demands the ultimate sacrifice for those who will be chosen to fly it.
Those are your pilots. Anything happens to them.
Smoke in the air! Smoke in the air!
You'll never forgive yourself.
No turning back now.
Come on!
Having any fun yet?
Our family film tonight, Chip and Dale Rescue Rangers, may not be a Disney classic, but is still one of the funniest films of the year so far. Decades after their successful TV series was cancelled, the beloved pair are now living separate lives of suburban domesticity in modern-day Los Angeles. When a former castmate mysteriously disappears, Chip and Dale must repair their broken friendship and take on their Rescue Rangers detective roles once again.
Over here!
Go get him!
This is awesome!
I was always more of an Alvin and the Chipmunks person.
You monster.
On DVD and Blu-ray, One of Us, Uncharted and The Way Back are also worth a look.
The Caxton Theatre in Grimsby have been entertaining local people with touring shows and in-house productions for over 75 years. I caught up with actor Michael Main to find out about their latest production, Noel Gwynn.
Our latest production, Noel Gwynn, should have gone on before the
COVID pandemic. But now we've got the opportunity to put it on. It's a comedy play based loosely on the history of Nell Gwynn, who was the mistress of King Charles II. It starts with her beginning her life in the theatre, her relationship with Charles and the court, and then finally she evolves into the Nell Gwynn of all the stories that we've heard. My character is Mr. Killigrew, and he is the actor-manager of Drury Lane, and he has the dubious honour of trying to get plays onto the stage. The other characters in the cast are Nell Gwynn, obviously, King Charles II. There's a funny character called Kynaston, who is the person who, the man who has played the women for all these years. Then suddenly, King Charles says, we will have real women on the stage. And he feels considerably threatened. A good night out, a really funny play, right? There are lots of inferences. It's a bit like you'll want to come back and see it again because there may be things you missed. Little lines which relate to things like Shakespeare or common comedies and things like that. A lot of things have been built into this so that there are layers and layers and layers of humour.
Now Gwynn runs from the 23rd to the 30th of July. Tickets are available now from the theatre website. More entertainment news now in Box Office with journalist and broadcaster Gemma Lingard.
Thank you very much, Ted. Well, we've got King Pleasure and the Biscuit Boys, and they are coming to the East Riding Theatre in Beverley on the 22nd of July. They've performed in more than 21 countries in their 30 years on the road, and they are more than just the world's greatest jump, jive and swing band. They're an institution. Jimmy Carr pays a visit to the Skegness Embassy Theatre on the 17th of July with his terribly funny 2.0 tour. Jimmy will be telling us jokes about all kinds of terrible things. Terrible things that might have affected you or people you know and love. But they're just jokes. They are not the terrible things.
Hello, I'm Jimmy Carr, and I've added lots of dates to my Terribly Funny 2.0 tour. Now, if you saw the Netflix special, His Dark Material, come and see the show again because it's all brand new. And if you saw the Terribly Funny tour last year, come and see it again because it's all brand new stuff.
At the New Theatre Royal in Lincoln on the 6th of July is Who Killed Agatha Christie? Come along for the ride with this enthralling West End comedy thriller that will keep you guessing right until the very end. On Monday the 4th and Tuesday the 5th of July, Dinosaur World Live is coming to the Grimsby Auditorium. Grab your compass and join our intrepid explorer across uncharted territories to discover a prehistoric world of astonishing and remarkably lifelike dinosaurs. Meet a host of impressive creatures and every child's favourite, and mine, the Tyrannosaurus Rex. And finally, at Hull City Hall, it's Adam Ant, the king of the wild frontier, will be performing his classic chart-topping singles and personal favourites, including Prince Charming, Stand and Deliver, and Goody Two Shoes on the 10th of July.
Well, that's almost all for tonight's show. You can keep up to date with the latest news on our Facebook page. And to make sure you don't miss any of our programmes, click the subscribe button below. If you have a story you would like us to feature on Billboard, email details to news@billboardtv.uk. From everyone on the Billboard team, thank you for joining us, and we look forward to seeing you next month for more entertainment news, entertaining guests and great music.
treasure token.